rescue you.
Junior, I'm not the one who needs rescuing.
I am never leaving this island paradise.
Rescue York.
When we look back at the pages of wrestling over three decades, one man arrives at every scene. Whether you call him as a Lionheart, Y2J, the best in the world, the Painmaker, the Alpha, or Le Champion, he able to reinvent himself time and time again. This man by now has worked for 10 different promotions all over the world. He totally had 2,446 matches as mentioned in cagematch.net. Also, he held 22 different championships across different promotions. As many wrestlers try to find success outside of wrestling, but no one will reach his level. This man himself is a great author, has his own podcast, and also has a rock band. Today we will take a deep look of legendary career of Chris Jericho. With my pleasure, I welcome all wrestling fans and friends of Jericho to the documentary of legendary Chris Jericho.
A little bit of the bubbly.
Try it on, man!
The man went on to become the Painmaker. Christopher Keith Irwin was born on November 9, 1917 in New York to a Canadian couple of Loretta Irwin and Ted Irwin. By the time of his birth, his father was a ice hockey player. He was playing for New York Rangers. When his father retired from ice hockey, Ted and his family moved to Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada. Christopher grew up in Winnipeg and became his idol was late great Owen Hart. Owen Hart's various high-flying moves reached his heart and mind, and Keith Irwin made a decision that he's going to become a professional wrestler. He attended Red River College in Winnipeg. He was graduated with a bachelor's degree in creative communications. Christopher's first wrestling experience came as he worked as a ring crew in Keystone Wrestling Alliance promotion. At the age of 19, Chris entered the legendary Hart Brothers School of Wrestling. On his very first day, he met Lance Storm. The name Chris Jericho itself has a story. As he revealed, "My initial name was going to be Jake Action. However, someone remarked to me that the name was stupid. Then they asked me what his name really was. He then got nervous and said Chris Jericho." The man who became very close friend to him in future was Lance Storm. Chris Jericho was trained by E.D. Langley and Brad Young. After a month of training, Chris Jericho made his professional role became a great tag team as they made their tag team debut as Sudden Impact. They both worked for Canadian Rocky Mountain Wrestling. They also worked along with Edge, Christine and Rhino. Chris Jericho and Lance Storm also traveled to Japan to work for Frontier Martial Arts Wrestling. From 1993 to 1995, Chris Jericho competed in Mexico's oldest promotion, CMLL. He had some amazing matches against Ultimo Dragon. After returning to USA, he and Lance Storm went on to work for Jim Cornette's Smoky Mountain Wrestling promotion, where they worked as thrill seekers. After spending years on Smoky Mountain, he went on to work for a Japanese promotion called Wrestling and Romance. This promotion became the birth of the Lionheart's character. In 1995, Jericho lost to Gedo in the final of the tournament to crown the inaugural War International Junior Heavyweight Champion. Later that year, Chris Jericho joined his first faction called Fuki Army. Fuki Army consists of Jado, Gedo and Chris Jericho, who was named as Lion Doe. In 1996, Chris Jericho and Gedo won the International Junior Heavyweight Tag Team Championship. After finding success in Japan, Chris returned to state as he joined extreme promotion called Extreme Championship Wrestling. It was reported that Chris Benoit, Dave Meltzer and Mick Foley had recommended Chris Jericho to the promoter of ECW, Paul Heyman. After joining ECW, he won the ECW World Television Championship in June 1996 at Hardcore Heaven. He wrestled some big names like Two Cold Scorpio, Shane Douglas, Taz, Sabu and Rob Van Dam. A major company around that time kept eye on Chris Jericho as they asked him to join the promotion. It was World Championship Wrestling, WCW, a company that had been competing with World Wrestling Federation. This was a real test for Chris as this was his first biggest promotion to work for. Jericho made his televised WCW Nitro debut on September 15, and he also won his first match against Alex Wright. His first pay-per-view debut arrived as he faced his friend Chris Benoit at Fall Brawl 1996. He briefly worked in the Cruiserweight division for about a year. On June 28, 1997, Chris Jericho defeated Six in Los Angeles, California to win the WCW Cruiserweight Championship for the first time in his career. Chris felt that his babyface character is not getting over, so he decided to turn heel. His heel work began when he won the Cruiserweight title third time by defeating Rey Mysterio Jr. at Sold Out. After the match, Jericho assaulted Mysterio's knee with a toolbox. The next feud with Dean Malenko would be regarded as one of the best things happening in WCW, as it gave birth to Man of 1004 Holds. During March 30, 1998 episode of Nitro, the most famous incident happened as he pulled out a long pile of paper that listed each of the 1004 holds. At Uncensored, Jericho wrestled Malenko and defeated him. Malenko was off TV for a while. J.J. Dillon scheduled a Cruiserweight Battle Royal, the winner of which would immediately have a shot at Jericho's Cruiserweight Championship. An individual who appeared to be Cyclops won the Battle Royal. He removed his mask and it was returning Dean Malenko. Following one of the loudest crowd reaction in WCW history, Malenko proceeded to defeat Jericho for the championship. For months, Chris continued to battle for the championship against Dean Malenko and Rey Mysterio. On August 10, Jericho defeated Stevie Ray to win the World Television Championship. This is his second title victory in WCW. As part of the working relationship between New Japan Pro Wrestling and World Championship Wrestling, Chris Jericho made his New Japan Pro Wrestling debut as Super Liger. Sadly, this gimmick didn't last long as Jericho had difficulty seeing through the mask. The next 6 months, Jericho would work without mask. Chris then went back to WCW. Chris Jericho as a TV champion repeatedly called out WCW World Heavyweight Champion at the time, Goldberg, in an attempt to begin a feud with him, but he never actually wrestled him. It was told Bischoff, Goldberg and Hulk Hogan refused to book Jericho in a pay-per-view squash match loss against Goldberg, which Jericho felt would be a big draw. This was a major reason for Chris Jericho leaving the company. Jericho's final WCW match came during a Illinois House show, July 21, where he and Eddie Guerrero lost to Billy Kidman and Rey Mysterio Jr. in a tag team match. Chris Jericho signed a contract with World Wrestling Federation. In the weeks before Jericho's debut, a clock labeled Countdown to New Millennium appeared on WWF programming. Jericho stated, he was inspired to do this as his entrance when he saw a similar clock in the post office. and Vince McMahon approved its use as his introduction to the WWF. It started a great relationship between Chris Jericho and Vince McMahon. The clock finally ran out on the org. This debut was an iconic debut, and the crowd reaction showed that. Chris Jericho introduced himself as Y2J. Jericho's first major feud was against the 9th Wonder of the World, China, for the WWF Intercontinental Championship. Jericho captured his first championship in WWF when he defeated China to win the Intercontinental Championship. After having battled with China, Jericho entered a feud with his late great friend Chris Benoit. Jericho lost the WWF Intercontinental title to European champion Kurt Angle at No Way Out. Jericho's first ever WrestleMania, in which he competed in a triple threat match against Chris Benoit and Angle at WrestleMania 2000. Chris Jericho won the European Championship by beating Chris Benoit. On the April 17 episode of Raw, Chris referee Earl Hebner made a fast count when Jericho pinned Triple H, causing Jericho to win the title. Hebner later reversed the decision due to the pressure from Triple H, and WWE does not recognize Jericho's reign as champion. The classic between Jericho and Benoit continued as at the 2001 Royal Rumble, Jericho defeated Chris Benoit in a ladder match to win WWF Intercontinental Championship for the fourth time. Jericho and Benoit formed a tag team, which saw them capturing WWF tag titles as they defeated Stone Cold Steve Austin and Triple H. In the following months, Jericho became a major force in the Invasion storyline, in which WCW and ECW joined forces to overtake WWF. At No Mercy, Chris Jericho captured WCW Championship when he pinned The Rock. In 2000, a WWE-produced VHS tape documenting Jericho's career titled Break Down the Walls was released. Irvine married Jessica Lockhart on July 13, 2000. After a month, Chris Jericho made a history in wrestling as at Vengeance he defeated both The Rock for a world championship and Stone Cold Steve Austin for his first WWF championship WWF champion. At the time, Jericho was at top of wrestling. He became the main eventer in World Wrestling Federation as he wished to be in WCW, but he never could. Chris Jericho's dream of main eventing WrestleMania arrived as he defended his title against Triple H at WrestleMania 18. After dropping titles to Triple H, Chris Jericho was drafted to SmackDown. As for some reason, he was unwilling to work in SmackDown. He was quickly being drafted to Raw as he started a feud that became one of the greatest feud of all time, as Jericho went on to face his idol Shawn Michaels. They both met at the grandest stage of wrestling, WrestleMania 19. This is one of all-time great match, which we awarded as number 1 in top 100 matches of Chris Jericho. After the match, Jericho, however, attacked Michaels with a low blow, furthering his heel character. On October 27 episode of Raw, Jericho won his 6th WWE Intercontinental Championship when he defeated Rob Van Dam. After having a betrayal from Trish Stratus, Jericho turned babyface. Jericho broke the record as he won the WWE Intercontinental Championship at Unforgiven in a ladder match against Christian, breaking the previous record held by Jeff Jarrett. Chris Jericho's contribution to wrestling continued as he invented Money in the Bank match concept. He also competed in the first ever Money in the Bank match at WrestleMania 21. Extreme Championship Wrestling One Night Stand arrived as he met his old friend Lance Storm at ECW One Night Stand. This was Lance Storm's final wrestling match in mainstream. On August 22 episode of Raw, Jericho faced Cena in a You Are Fired match. Jericho was fired by Raw General Manager Eric Bischoff. Jericho's WWE contract expired on August 25. Jericho was the lead singer for the heavy metal band Fosse since 2000. He continued to sing for Fosse. He also traveled around the world as part of Fosse's tour. Chris Jericho also started acting in movies, notably 2010's MacGruber, 2015's Oh Hell No, 2016's Nine Legends. Also, Jericho contributed as a stage actor in comedy play Opening Night, which premiered at the Toronto Center for the Arts during July 20-22, 2006 in Toronto. In 2007, Chris Jericho released his first book called A Lion's Tale. He details his life from his early years to his debut for World Wrestling Entertainment on August 9, 1999. The book became the New York Times bestseller. On July 5, 2004, Irvine was awarded Manitoba's Order of the Buffalo Hunt for his achievements in wrestling and his commitment to working with underprivileged children. Taking a two-year break from professional wrestling made Chris Jericho even more big star. Fans were desperate for him and were asking when he is going to make his return. The answer arrived, as after 2 year disappearance on television, video packages continued to play on the screen. The videos contained hidden messages and biblical links related to Jericho when he interrupted Randy Orton during Orton's passing of the torch ceremony. Jericho revealed his intention to reclaim WWE Championship in order to save WWE fans from Orton. Jericho's in-ring return was scheduled. Chris Jericho defeated Santino Marella and debuted a new finishing move called the Coat Breaker. Jericho continued to feud with WWE Champion Randy Orton. At Armageddon, he competed in a WWE title match against Randy Orton, defeating him by disqualification when JBL interfered in the match. He began a feud with JBL and met him at Royal Rumble. On March 10 episode of Raw, Jericho captured the WWE Intercontinental Championship for a record 8th time when he defeated the charismatic enigma Jeff Hardy. After a while, Jericho re-entered a feud with Shawn Michaels. This led to a match between Michaels and Jericho at Judgment Day. WrestleMania 19 repeated, as Michaels defeated Jericho, but after the match, Jericho initiated a handshake with Shawn Michaels. This segment made Jericho as one of the most talked about wrestlers, as he pointed out that Michaels was still cheered by the fans despite Michaels' defeat and attack on Jericho during the previous months, whereas Jericho was booed when he tried to do the right thing. Jericho then assaulted Michaels with a low blow and sent Michaels through the Jerrytron 5000 television, damaging the eye of Michaels and turning heel. The line worst is afterward, Chris Jericho developed a suit-wearing persona inspired by Javier Bardem's character from 2007 film No Country for Old Men. Jericho and Michaels met at the Great American Bash, which Jericho won after attacking the cut on Michaels' eye. This was first major win over Shawn Michaels. They met in an unsanctioned match at Unforgiven, which Jericho lost by referee stoppage. Even though he lost this match, he able to attend championship scramble match as he replaced WWE champion CM Punk. And Jericho won the World Heavyweight Championship by defeating Batista, JBL, Kane and Rey Mysterio. The rivalry between Michaels and Jericho continued as they faced at No Mercy in a ladder match, which Jericho won. On December 8 episode of Raw, Jericho was awarded the Slammy Award for 2008 Superstar of the Year. Following this, Jericho began a rivalry with veteran wrestlers Ric Flair, Ricky Steamboat, Jimmy Snuka and Roddy Piper. On April 13 episode of Raw, Jericho was drafted to SmackDown as part of 2009 WWE draft. At Night of Champions, Jericho revealed Big Show as his new tag team partner, creating a team that would come to called Jericho. The duo defeated Cody Rhodes and Ted DiBiase to retain the championship. Jericho successfully defended the titles against Crime Time at SummerSlam, MVP and Mark Henry at Breaking Point, and Rey Mysterio and Batista at Hell in a Cell. They both made a one hell of a team. However, they were defeated by D-Generation X, a team of Shawn Michaels and Triple H. Following episode of Raw, Mike Tyson betrayed Jericho and knocked him out. After Royal Rumble 2010, Jericho won the Elimination Chamber match to become World Heavyweight Champion again. The next night on Raw, Edge used his Royal Rumble win to challenge Jericho for World Heavyweight Championship match at WrestleMania 26. Jericho defeated Edge at WrestleMania to retain the title. Jericho and Edge continued their feud leading into Extreme Rules, where Jericho was defeated in a steel cage match. Chris Jericho was drafted to Raw brand in 2010 WWE draft. On September 27 episode of Raw, Chris Jericho faced Randy Orton, who punted him in the head. This was used to explain Jericho's departure from the company. Jericho later told in the WWE.com that he wouldn't be a full-time superstar again during his career due to his music commitments with the band Fosse. Chris Jericho released his second book called Undisputed, How to Become the World Champion in 1372 Easy Steps. In June 2010, Chris Jericho was named the host of the ABC primetime game show called The Downfall. On March 1, 2011, Chris Jericho was named one of the contestants on 2011 lineup of Dancing with Stars. This Sunday at Royal Rumble, it's going to be the end of the world as you know it. After failing to win Royal Rumble on the January 30 episode of Raw, Chris Jericho began a feud with WWE champion CM Punk. After attacking him during his match with Daniel Bryan, Chris Jericho won a 10-man battle royal to become the number one contender for Punk's WWE Championship at WrestleMania 28. But at WrestleMania 28, CM Punk defeated Chris Jericho in a great match to retain his championship. Chris Jericho continued to feud with CM Punk in the weeks that followed. At Extreme Rules, Chris Jericho failed to capture the WWE Championship again from Punk in a Chicago street fight match. One of Chris Jericho's strange days arrived as a WWE live event in Brazil. Jericho wrestled a match against CM Punk, during which Chris Jericho kicked a Brazilian flag, causing local police to intervene and threatened Jericho with arrest. Chris Jericho issued an apology to the audience, enabling the event to resume. The following day, WWE suspended Chris Jericho for 30 days while apologizing to the people and the government of Brazil. On January 27, 2013, Chris Jericho returned after a 5-month entering the Royal Rumble match as the second entrant. Chris Jericho lasted over 47 minutes before being eliminated by Dolph Ziggler. Chris Jericho's willing to put over other young guys came to scene as he had a feud with Fandango, which led to their match at WrestleMania 29. As Fandango went on to defeat Chris Jericho, after having a loss at WrestleMania, he started a feud with Bray Wyatt. After losing to him in a steel cage match in January 2015, Chris Jericho revealed that he signed an exclusive WWE contract, under which he would compete at 16 house shows only. During this time, he wrestled against the likes of Luke Harper, Kevin Owens and King Barrett in winning efforts. In May 2015, Chris Jericho was one of the hosts of Tough Enough's sixth season. Chris Jericho made his televised return at Beast in an East, defeating Neville. On January 4, 2016 episode of Raw, Chris Jericho returned to in-ring competition full-time and confronted The New Day. At the 2016 Royal Rumble, Chris Jericho entered as the sixth entrant, lasting over 15 minutes before being eliminated by Dean Ambrose. New face arrived at the scene as a veteran in professional wrestling made his debut at Royal Rumble. It was the phenomenal himself, AJ Styles. On Jan 25 episode of Raw, Chris Jericho faced the AJ Styles in a losing effort. Following the match, after initial hesitation by Jericho, the pair shook hands. On the February 11 episode of SmackDown, Chris Jericho went on to defeat AJ Styles. They had their rubber match at Fastlane. At Fastlane, Styles was victorious in the third match between the pair. On February 22 episode of Raw, Chris Jericho and AJ Styles formed a tag team dubbed a Y2AJ. Y2AJ was crazily over the fans. Following their loss against the New Day on March 7 episode of Raw, Chris Jericho attacked AJ Styles, ending their alliance. Their feud culminated at WrestleMania 32, where Chris Jericho defeated AJ Styles. After that, Chris Jericho had a very little fun feud against Dean Ambrose, which ended in an asylum match at Royal Rumble, which Dean Ambrose won over Chris Jericho. On July 19 at 2016 WWE Draft, Chris Jericho was drafted to Raw brand. Chris Jericho then entered a feud with Enzo and Cass. Chris Jericho aligned with Kevin Owens and later defeated Amore via DQ when Cass interfered. This led to a tag team match at SummerSlam, where Chris Jericho and Kevin Owens defeated Enzo and Cass. The list of Jericho soon became incredibly popular with the fans, with many critics describing Chris Jericho and his list as easily one of the best moments of Raw's broadcast. Kevin Owens and Chris Jericho made a team that became dominant force on Raw. Tension between Chris Jericho and Owens arose after Chris Jericho lost to Rollins. Chris Jericho won the United States Championship from Roman Reigns in a handicap match. Thus, Chris Jericho won his first championship in nearly 7 years and also became a Grand Slam winner. In February, tensions grew between Jericho and Owens after Chris Jericho accepted a Universal Championship challenge from Bill Goldberg on Owens' behalf. On the February 13 episode of Raw, Chris Jericho held a face return at Fastlane on March 5, distracting Owens during his match with Goldberg and causing Kevin Owens to lose the Universal Championship. This led to a match between Chris Jericho and Kevin Owens for on being arranged WrestleMania 33 on April 2, with Jericho's United States Championship on the line. At WrestleMania, Chris Jericho lost the United States Championship to Kevin Owens. Following that match, Chris Jericho won the title back but once again lost the title to Owens. Following the match, Kevin Owens attacked Chris Jericho, who was carried out on a stretcher. On the other hand, Chris Jericho continued to swing high outside of wrestling as he released a new song called Judas, which became his best work on his music career. Chris Jericho also released his third book called Best in the World, At What I Have No Idea. Chris Jericho started his own podcast too called Talk is Jericho. On January 22, 2018, during 25th anniversary of Raw, Chris Jericho appeared in backstage segment with Elias, putting him on the list of Jericho. It was his last backstage segment on WWE. At the Greatest Royal Rumble, Chris Jericho was the last entrant in a 50-man Royal Rumble match, eliminating Shelton Benjamin before being eliminated by Braun Strowman. This event marked Jericho's final appearance with WWE. Jericho told WWE that he is interested in working in different promotion, as no one thought this would happen, but the Painmaker made his shocking return to New Japan Pro Wrestling by challenging his fellow Canadian Kenny Omega to a match at Wrestle Kingdom. Though he made a return to New Japan Pro Wrestling, but he was still working for WWE. The match dubbed Alpha vs Omega was Jericho's first match outside of WWE since he left WCW in 1999. Chris Jericho returned in person at December 11 World Tag League Show, attacking and bloodying Kenny Omega after his match. The following day at Wrestle Kingdom 12 in Tokyo Dome press conference, Chris Jericho and Omega would get into a second physical altercation. Because of the two incidents, New Japan turned the Jan 4 match into a no disqualification match. At the event, Chris Jericho was defeated by Kenny Omega. It was later revealed that the match was awarded a 5-star rating from Dave Meltzer of the Wrestling Observer newsletter. This was first of his career. The night after Wrestle Kingdom 12 in Tokyo Dome at New Year Dash 2018, Chris Jericho attacked Tetsuya Naito. This led to a match at Dominion 6.9 in Osaka Joe Hall, when Chris Jericho won and captured IWGP Intercontinental Championship. Despite Chris Jericho stating that Naito would not receive a match, the match was made official for Wrestle Kingdom 13. During a Road to Tokyo Dome show, Chris Jericho laid out Tetsuya Naito with steel chair shots, and after stated that at Wrestle Kingdom 13 he would end Tetsuya Naito's career. At the event, Chris Jericho was defeated by Tetsuya Naito, losing the IWGP Intercontinental Championship. At the same time, the Elite were hosting the biggest independence wrestling show called All In. The world was shocked once again as Chris Jericho became the talk about superstar as he shockingly attacked Kenny Omega. This event led to Vince McMahon furious over Chris Jericho. Chris Jericho used Tony Khan's private jet to fly over to All In show. Chris Jericho went public that he is no longer working for World Wrestling Entertainment. Many were wondering and asked why Chris Jericho left WWE. The Alpha gave his reason. Originally, that was going to be the main event for the world title. Kevin Owens was the champion, and I was going to beat him in the main event of WrestleMania as a babyface. Instead of having Chris Jericho and Kevin Owens as the main event, Vince McMahon decided to put Bill Goldberg and Brock Lesnar on the main card. Vince said that it's going to be me versus Kevin Owens for the world title at WrestleMania, and you're going to win the title. Next week he doesn't tell me, but I hear that he's changed to Brock Lesnar versus Goldberg for the title. And not only did he take us out of the main event, and once again just because I was told I have no right to do it, and things change all the time, I'm a big boy, I can handle it. But to take us from the main event slot and then move us to the second match on the card, that has 12 matches on it, I was like, that's a effing insult. In October 2018, Chris Jericho organized Chris Jericho's Rock and Wrestling Rager at Sea, a series of professional wrestling matches originating from Chris Jericho's cruise ship. Chris Jericho made an expecting debut for All Elite Wrestling in AEW Double or Nothing media conference. The following next month, Chris Jericho confronted his familiar foe, Kenny Omega, and challenged him to a match at Double or Nothing. Double or Nothing arrived as Chris Jericho defeated Kenny Omega and moved one step closer to become the first ever AEW World Champion. Following AEW's All Out, Chris Jericho defeated Hangman Page to become the first ever World Champion. Chris Jericho was once again at the top of the world and showed age doesn't matter in wrestling. On the first ever Dynamite, Chris Jericho made a huge impact in All Elite Wrestling as he formed his new faction called the Inner Circle, consisting of the Spanish God Sammy Guevara, Santana, Ortiz, and the debuting Jake Hager, and the leader himself, Le Champion Chris Jericho. The Inner Circle dominated AEW as Chris Jericho defeated Cody Rhodes. Santana and Ortiz went on to defeat the Young Bucks at Full Gear. The next feud with Moxley had a great build as Chris Jericho damaged the eye of Moxley. Revolution arrived as Jon Moxley defeated Chris Jericho to win the AEW World Championship. Chris Jericho's mission to put AEW on map was over, and then he decided to put over the other new guys in the company. Chris Jericho took place in the first ever Stadium Stampede match, as Inner Circle lost to the Elite. The baddest man on the planet, Mike Tyson, crossed once again in Chris Jericho's line, as they had a brawl on Dynamite. Orange Cassidy arrived the scene, as he and Jericho went on to have a series of matches. Chris Jericho put over Orange as Orange Cassidy defeated him in a Mimosa Mayhem match at All Out 2020. After making Orange Cassidy as a main event star, he took Maxwell Jacob Friedman in his wing. As MJF and Jericho went on to have a match at Full Gear, with stipulation of if MJF wins, he will join Inner Circle. MJF won the match. MJF and Wardlow joined the Inner Circle. Chris Jericho again made a short kick move as he decided to appear on Stone Cold's Broken Skull Sessions. As Chris Jericho went on to say, it was lightning in a bottle sort of thing with Vince McMahon, and Tony Khan gave their approval. Chris Jericho said, I think it was also well timed. The Peacock relationship with WWE was just starting. They wanted something huge out of the gate. It was perfect for us considering AEW had its first unopposed show without NXT. Once that big Dynamite rating came in though, I think Vince may have had a little bit of second guessing. Chris Jericho added, would they do it again? Maybe. I don't know if you can find anyone with respect and goodwill on both sides that would allow that. If they don't do it again, it was one of the coolest moments in wrestling history. Tension between Inner Circle grew as initial member Sammy Guevara quit the Inner Circle. MJF and Wardlow swerved the whole world as they joined with FTR and Shawn Spears to form the Pinnacle. The Pinnacle and the Inner Circle had battles over various stipulations. First, it was the blood and guts match. MJF proved he is a rat, as after Pinnacle won the match, MJF threw Chris Jericho off the steel cage. Stadium Stampede match arrived with a stipulation of if Pinnacle win, Inner Circle should quit. But it never happened as Sammy Guevara won the match for the Inner Circle. MJF and Chris Jericho are now at the end of their feud, as MJF played the labors of Jericho against Chris. Chris have to defeat four other wrestlers to have a match against MJF. Looking back at his career, Chris Jericho done everything in his life, and at the age of 50, he is still going on fire. His work to this business will never be forgotten. Without him, I would never start this channel. Surely, without a doubt, he will be one of Mount Rushmore of wrestling. Over 4 decades, he is a face of wrestling, no matter which company he worked. He is truly the god of war. So, on behalf of all fans and Jericholics, thank you, Chris Jericho.